from where I sit, there can be a lot of obstacles when it comes to travel, and a lot of people telling me, no, you can't, just because I don't walk. But they don't know me. Having a disability and being in a wheelchair has been a blessing, and I refuse to let it hold me back from seeing the world and living my best life. I have flown in a hot air balloon, been ziplining, ridden in an amphicar, and absolutely love traveling. Sure, there are things I need to figure out along the way, but from where I sit, everything looks just fine.
Hi everyone, it's Jamie with Adventures by Jamie. For those of you that are new here and don't know this very good looking guy next to me, you know, what are you looking for?
Well, I'm looking for this guy, but there's just a tree behind.
Oh, I'm talking about you.
Oh, well.
Yes. So this very good looking guy next to me is my boyfriend, Kevin. And we are an inter-abled couple. Not sure that you can really tell, but I am in a wheelchair due to muscular dystrophy. And Kevin is not. He walks.
I am very tall.
He's very tall. He's 6'4". So us, you know, out and about and him standing next to me, there's just a little bit of a height discrepancy. But, you know, that's okay.
Yeah, I cleared the cobwebs out of the way so she can scoot along.
Yeah, he's good for that. But we are going to share with you about our adventure in a hot air balloon. But before we get into that, make sure that you click on that subscribe button and hit the bell so you never miss a future video. Yeah, so what, about a year ago, I think?
Yeah, I think it was like last year.
Yeah, we were
wrong. It was like the 4th of July.
It was the 4th of
July. 4th of July, yeah.
Oh my gosh, 4th of July a year ago, so 2019.
It was the calmest day.
It was, but we had been trying to go on a hot air balloon ride for quite some time. First of all, finding a hot air balloon company that is accessible, because hot air balloons that you can take a full power wheelchair on are few and far between.
Their baskets are really small. This one was quite large.
Yeah.
And even then, it presented some challenges to get it in. We had to use a ramp.
Right. It was, for all intents and purposes, it was quite simple, you know, but I had called around to quite a few hot air balloon companies and they didn't have accessible balloons. And we ended up going with the American Balloon Company in Wesley Chapel, Florida. And the experience was unbelievable.
It was awesome.
Yeah. You planned so far in advance, and unfortunately for us, the first time, the date we planned, it ended up being like literally either a tropical storm or a hurricane that ended up coming through.
Yeah, it was pretty terrible.
So that didn't work.
You don't want to be up there.
No. And then the next time, it just was a really, really windy day. And they let us know, too, that they were being extraordinarily cautious. Not that they're not cautious all the time, but because I am in the wheelchair and, you know, flying with someone with a disability is different. So they were taking extra precautions.
Yeah.
So we got up to about 500 feet in the air.
Yeah, all those cows too. It was pretty cool. They're all like,
what's going on?
Yeah. And the morning sky was beautiful.
Yeah, watching the sunrise from a hot air balloon, you guys. Oh my goodness. Now, we've done hot air balloons at Disney Springs, but you are, you're
like
tandemed
this
to the ground. So you go up, you come right down. This, we were not tandemed. We were going wherever the wind took us.
Yeah, it didn't take us too far because it was such a calm day. I think they were looking for a day that would be safe for Jamie because, you know, a lot can go wrong with people and with disabilities, and you know, and you got this heavy chair.
Yeah, the chair without me in it, you guys, is 400 pounds. Now, granted, I'm only about 100 pounds, but so we're talking about 500 pounds, just me alone. So they have to account for weight, too. So it was myself, Kevin, and then the pilot. And granted, I don't think there was much more room in the hot air balloon for anyone else.
No, there wasn't. It's not even close to like what a going up in a jet or an airplane, because you miss that. You know, things move too fast.
Yeah, this is very, I didn't know what to
expect. With this, you're just kind of like, you're like a bubble. You just float up, and then the wind carries you, and then you, well, when they decide to come down,
you're up for about an hour. You know, that's really what to expect, whether you know, the wind takes you miles and miles away, or like us, it was very, very calm, and it just literally took us like across a major road.
but there was about an hour. There was a lagoon there, and this was all new construction. They had guys that were cleaning the pool, anticipating that people were going to party there because
it was a grand opening.
Yeah, it was the 4th of July, so you're going to have some action. And as the balloon came down, it was like
skimming over this lagoon.
It was like, and like you were like an angel descending from the heavens.
I can't even imagine what that guy must have thought.
They just stopped when they saw this ginormous balloon just come down. And then out came the cell phones, and they're all like, and then trailing you down. And we got within like 2 inches of the lagoon
water.
So we were just gliding off just the surface, you know, almost, you know, but like maybe that high from it.
Yeah.
And you could smell the water.
Can you imagine literally like you're that guy?
I mean, it's not a bad smell, but you know, it's chlorine.
No, chlorine. So. But you're that guy cleaning the pool, and all, you know, you see this hot air balloon and you're like, oh, that's cool. And it's just been descending literally almost on top of you. Like, that is crazy.
We went back to the hotel.
Yes.
We started out in a hotel, and then we went back to that same hotel and celebrated with the champagne.
A champagne toast. And, you know, at the end of that, I called my parents because I was just so excited about the experience. And they had no idea that we were... we were going up, and I'm like, oh, so guess what Kevin and I did today? You know, we went up in a hot
air. Yeah, what? Yeah. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, like, I'm alive, it's okay. Yeah, I think we're a little crazy with all of the adventures that Kevin and I have. But we have to show you the souvenir that they gave us.
Yeah,
the souvenir that they gave us from our champagne bottle. It was just, and they made this right in front of us. I just think that this is the coolest thing.
They repurposed some of the champagne bottle here to create.
It's like, I guess, an ornament?
An ornament that's supposed to resemble a balloon. But I had actually attached
the little
Christmas tree hanger. And a little loop on top so it can be attached. But that's what they did. They made a little memento.
Yeah.
And I guess was it a Barefoot brand?
Yeah. Barefoot. Mm-hmm. It was good.
There we go. You see the foot right there.
But yeah, it was so, you know, we have our little memento. So I'm curious if you guys would ever do that. I know a lot of people are like, oh no, you know, you're not getting me up that high with heights and all of that. So tell us in the comments below, would you go on a hot air balloon ride? Is that something that you've done before? And if so, where did you do it? You know, this literally was about 10 minutes from our house. So I would love maybe one day to do this over like the Grand Canyon or,
you know. Yeah, I've seen like shows about the Grand Canyon and like that's really like freaky to see that kind of thing. You know, it's like really, really, it doesn't seem like people understand how high up it is until they walk to the edge and it's
so
like,
imagine being in a hot air balloon over that. Like, oh my gosh. So I would love to have that, another experience like that, but definitely let us know in the comments below. And now we're going to show you just a little clip of our balloon ride. And so you can see all that we were talking about and what that experience was like.
But you have to like kind of like see it. You know, you might want to like, oh my gosh, how scary! What do I do? You gotta remember to pull your hands away from your
eyes.
Yes, because it's really not that scary.
No, it's not scary at all. Yeah. It is one of the most peaceful experiences that I've ever had, for sure. So thanks so much, guys. We are gonna definitely be back with more of our adventures from the series in From Where I Sit. And again, make sure to like this video, subscribe to our channel, and we'll be seeing you real soon.
Bye.
Would you like to ride in my beautiful balloon? Would you like to ride?